Hello, friends. Welcome back for another topic, rather another subtopic in acid-based indicators. And today we are going to see how acid do react with bases. Now, we've got an experiment here. See how the lead acid reacts with bases. Measure in milliliter of the lead sodium hydroxide solution. Put in it, I think, put it in a clean polymer flask. Add 2 to 3 drops of methylene and water. Not the color in the solution. Add dilute hydrochloric acid drop or drop by shaking the polymer flask. Count the number of drops till the indicator plastic is covered. Repeat the above experiment procedure without adding the indicator. And the same number of drops of hydrochloric acid to 10 milliliters of sodium hydroxide. Put the resulting solution in a refrigerating dish and heat the solution to saturation. Allow the saturated solution to cool and you record the observation. Now, another one, you are supposed to place a small sample of calcium oxide in the test tube. Add 2.5 milliliters of dilute nitric acid, shake the mixture. And that part is supposed to repeat the procedure. You see the following different test tube. Here we have zinc oxide, copper oxide, magnesium oxide, and lead 2 oxide. Got your observation in the table. Now, use the dilute hydrochloric acid in exchange for the dilute nitric acid. So what basically is happening here? The bases we have in our first column here, calcium oxide, copper 2 oxide, zinc oxide, magnesium oxide, lead 2 oxide. Then the acid, we are having here nitric acid, then the other side we have dilute hydrochloric acid. So these are basically what we are used to use here to test for conversion. So in other words, what has our basis here, reacting with acid. Then from what we've done, or rather from the reaction we've dealt with, we can get the kind of salt we want to get here. And if you find that any of this reaction doesn't proceed faster, you can warm to increase what we call activation energy. Therefore, the reaction can take place at a faster rate. Now, notice that you are being told that to add the methylene drop by drop here, you measure sodium hydroxide each surface, then you add 2 to 3 drops of the methylene, then you have the color, then you add the acid. Now, phenolphthalein at this reaction, we are adding phenolphthalein to get what we call endpoint. Endpoint is the reason why we are adding this phenolphthalein. So it's going to remind our liquid where the color changes. That is going to tell us the amount of acid that's needed exactly to neutralize the amount of base that was put in there. The reason as to why we are not using it in the next reaction is to avoid contamination. So the first bit we are using it to determine the endpoint, and after that, We are not using it in the neck, we are acting like the following reaction, because it will be an impurity. Already we determine the amount of acid that is needed to neutralize a given amount of base. So we find that when we are now carrying the experiment, we carry out the experiment without it. For example, the phenolphthalein is being the basic solution. So if you add the color you want to see, it's pink. But at any point when the base has been neutralized, the color changes the colors. So, for example, when we have 10 mm of base, then you add phenolphthalein, the color changes to pink. Then you start adding acid drop by drop until this color changes from pink to color. Suppose that you find that 6.5 milliliters of acid is when added and the color changes from pink to colorless, then we are talking about that one as the end point. Now, this kind of reaction is called a neutralization reaction, a reaction between acid and base. And the product of a neutralization reaction is going to be salt and water. Salt and water. What are we talking about here? Suppose we take this table here, take calcium oxide that dilute nitric acid. We're going to have calcium nitrate plus water. Calcium oxide plus the neutral boric acid. We're going to have calcium chloride plus water. So, as I was saying, when acid react with bases, we form salt and water as the only product. Salt and water are neutral products, and hence the reaction is defined as neutralization reaction. Sodium hydroxide react with the nitrate and the chloric acid to form sodium chloride and water. So the type of salt, after knowing that acid plus base gives salt plus water. Now the type of salt that is formed is going to depend on the type of acid used inside of the base, the type of base used. But in this case, water is going to be a constant factor in all neutralization reactions. For example, sodium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid, we are going to have a salt that contains sodium and hydrochloric acid, so and a chloride. So in other words, this salt can be able to predict that the overall sodium chloride plus the other substance is water. Sodium, calcium oxide plus hydrochloric acid. No calcium plus hydrochloride. Calcium, we are going to have one part of the metal, which is calcium plus hydrochloric. It's going to be a chloride plus water. Magnesium oxide plus nitric acid. We want to have magnesium plus nitric. Nitrate, so it's going to be magnesium nitrate plus water. Zinc oxide plus hydrochloric acid. Know that we're going to have zinc. From hydrochloric acid, we're going to have a chloride. So zinc chloride plus water. That's what we need. So, copper trioxide, we're going to have a copper plus sulfuric acid, copper sulfate plus water. So it's very easy to predict the kind of salt and that way. So in general, base plus an acid should be giving you a metal salt plus water. Anytime you're given base plus an acid, you should be given a metal salt and water. So metal oxide, metal hydroxide, and ammonia solution are bases. But the acids you can guess their name from where they are being added, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid. So, And the glory will always give us glory. And the glory will always give us glory. Sulfuric acid will give us sulfate. Nitric acid will give us nitrates. Phosphoric acid will always give us phosphate. So it will be copper, phosphate, aluminum, sulfate, magnesium, chloride. So then we understand on when the reactor is achieved. Or it's used for people. Now we are going to take our break at that point. When we come back, we are going to talk about properties.